Hello, so in this part we will be doing the inner details. So first off, style the curve, I'm trying to trace the edge of the gaps. This curve, dump down, up and down, let's extend this so that it intersects. So now let's trace it properly. So yeah, we got the outer trim line and now what I'm going to do is I'm going to select this surfaces that we created and then I will make a copy of surfaces. So I'll select this surface. This surface, this, and this. That's the surface that we needed. So I'll just make a copy, paste. Up here, hide this, and then okay, one more layer. Set all the curves in that. Yep, and then we go for blended curves. Blend curves from here to here. Then from here to here, from here to here, to here, then here. Alright, now we need to adjust. Now let's do the inner detail. So I'm gonna use the same curves. So I created a couple of layers, naming them as body 1 and 2, 3. So we'll go for 2 now. select the curves. I'll make it as a group. I'll set the pivot in the center, and then copy paste and scale it. Alright, and then we can hide. Since it's a group, we can easily select them and then we can hide this as well. So yeah, let's trace it. Curves, edit blend. Then this curve, bring it somewhere there and stretch this. This better we stretch this. Then we don't need this curve, so I'll delete them. This curve also no need. I don't want to make it too complex following the shape, but I think it's logically this should be matching somewhere here, because the flow is like that. So I'm just making a curve like that. I'm going to give a small blend like that. somewhat like that, and yeah, select all the curves, ungroup it, group it again, set pivot in the center. Now select this, we never selected that, so select all the curves, group it, set pivot in the center, yep, and then copy paste again, scale it down, and that's the outline for the third body, so we can assign it there for now, and then when we do that we will whatever we'll then adjust, yeah, and now we can change this to pickable. And then select the surface, 1, 2, 3, put it here, untrim this, untrim this, untrim, untrim, yep, untrim. I can delete. I'll keep it. Keep the curves. Because okay. So project, select on the surface. Selecting the curves, project, and then I guess set this now, hide it. Yeah. Alright, so now trim, I want this to be, so we need this one, as well, so let's see, keep, yep, alright. And then this, trim this part, this one, this, and then this, this, so from that side, this one, this. Let's see. I think we missed here. Root. So as you can see, we miss this surface and this surface, this surface. So I'll copy paste it here. Hand trim. Untrim. Okay. Untrim. Trim. Sam. Select the curl surface. Delete it. So yeah, and then we'll try fillet flange chain select. G2042. It's auto trim update. Let's see. Edit it. Keep it one then. And then again, set this. So it's better to always save, because the file is getting heavy, it could crash anytime. I think we can give it 2. So let's see what happens if you give it 2. Okay, so that completes our second part. Inside the second, I thought I copied it, but seems like I never copied the file. Copied the surface, sorry. So if you have saved it in stages, then it's very good. I mean, you can just bring the surfaces into this file. But if you never did it, you have to go select this surfaces that you copied. And then you have to untrim and then trim the surfaces back. So since I have the old version of it, I'll just copy paste the surfaces. So yeah, so I'll leave it there. Now I'll go for body 3, hide all, select, So I thought the mic was on, so no man, I think those steps are easy. What I did is I copy pasted from body 2 and then untrimmed it and then projected these curves and trimming it. Okay, so trim, we need this inside pieces, yeah, so we can hide the curves. So yeah, and then you can use mode section draft. So I'm selecting all the straight ones. Normal. And let's give a bit of length to it. And angle. I think we have to do it manually, but if we select, chain select and extrude it, we're going to have some weird surfaces. Without any, let's see, Bezier, explicit control, and degree line update. Okay, and so we need to increase the angle. Edit it. Make sure that these surfaces are intersecting the body tools flanges and flange length. Yeah, so you can hide second, and then I go for round. Keep G2. G2 10 don't only 10, just use 5 for now, and automatic update, trim automatic, just make a box over it. So you can see that there is a this is not positional to the surface. So we're not going to get a good result. But still, let's see. See, I said, anyway, it's like this, delete its history, and then let's see if we can edit. Positional. Increase use pants 2, 3, 4. Okay. And then we go for round again. Don't have a continuity here, so the same thing, align, increase the use spans, let's see. This should not be a problem. We can manually delete surface. Let's see if removing that surface is taking off that whole piece. Select this surface, hide and select. Let's trim. Again, what? Yep. Project this surface with this fillet, trim, that piece is gone, so this surface, delete. Okay, turn on this. Project the surface with this, fill that, trim. Assert the skin. I'm using skin to understand if we can select the whole edge or if there is any breaks in it. So create a curve from here to here, make it phi, align, do this, I'll go for square. So yeah, that's complete our body 3. Body 2. Alright, so I did not bring the surface yet, so yeah, I'm going to bring my old one and then. Alright, so now let's model the handle. Real estate maintenance. These two dump inside this, put it out, and I'll just see what else we have in this folder. Hide it. Hide this. Alright, select all. I'll put inside this. All there, and now we'll start creating our handle. Make this as inactive wireframe, and create a curve from here to here. Break it. So now the surfaces are blocking my view, in order to make this easier for us, I'll select this surface, body 2, select surface, select those two surfaces, copy, paste it here, and then I'll hide this. One more surface. This has one. Copy, paste. Yeah. All right. We trim this. As well. And then select the curves, copy paste here. Don't worry about how they're going to intersect the other surfaces, but you just have to select that and see vision. Start with the skin. Yeah, a bit of crown, and then here rail. So since we don't know how this thing is intersecting with the surfaces, I first create the handle surfaces that all we need. That's too much crown. Edit. So yeah, don't worry about these surfaces as of now. The main surfaces that we need to consider now at this point is these three, and then let's intersect this with this surface. and the surface. And now let's wireframe. If you see that the surfaces are intersecting here, which we don't need, select the curves, hide and select, align it. Let's try to slide the curves and pull it out a bit. Just giving it a little bit of form there, and then let's edit this surface now. From again. This curve, we don't need that. We'll delete the surface as well. created. First of all, we'll just extend it until the curve extended outside the form. Delete the curve on surface. Try to create a curve. And project this to that surface. Delete this. Stance and then make a skin. Default. Connect and explicit. In that case, we'll extend this, that, and extend this curve like that. We'll edit this, make it default, and then the shade is getting darker at somewhere here, so let's create a curve here like that. Project trim. Create a curve from here to here, and then here stretch this, and then select the surface curve, hide and select, align this to this, edit it G2. Fit. Select the curve and let's move the curve to this. another curve here. And select this curve, send this. I1, Z2. I'll stretch this. We'll just try to extend the curve itself. Yep, and then project this. Trim. So this surface and this. Hide and select. These two curves, copy, paste it, align it here, let's make it a monorail, undo it, make it 2, curvature explicit. Same here, it's starting somewhere here, like that. We'll extend this car. Then project this curve onto this surface. So now we have 3, and then we can just use rail. Delete the curve surface, select this surface, trim convert, and then and then with the square we'll align it to this G2. Yep. And wireframe project, and go for rail again. Rail one, we want position. It is okay, weight is fading there. Wireframe again. Move this a bit. Let's hide and then project. So surface. Trim. Trim. Set these two surfaces and select curve. Copy paste line. Yep. And then inside it for rail again. Undo, copy paste, line, see, just like this with this, it's going somewhere which we don't need, and so let's edit this. This as well. Should be fine. And select this curve, we don't need that one now. We want this curve, copy paste. I and then what to say. Similarly, we need to create in the bottom, and let's see here how it is intersecting. Alright. This is okay as well. And then let's copy this curve, copy, paste, and put it here. Okay, and then the wireframe. Extend this line a bit and protect this line onto this surface. I'm gonna go for skin again. So here, default, get default, and then we will do a reel. Gen 1 is curvature explicit. Okay, wireframe again. We'll protect this curve onto the surface. Paste that curve here and go for real again. Line the edit to, and then we intersect the surface with this. Then we do the same here, copy. Before copying, we need to trim, so project. It's another curve. Copy paste. Trim. Line skin, and then select this surface, this curve, and this curve. Hide and select. Curvature. Then intersect this, that. So yep, we got all the surfaces that we need to model the boundary of this handle. I'll see the details in a while, but yeah, that's how we do it. So I'll select the surfaces. I don't select, and we'll go for tubular offset. Select all, unhide, hide. And then go for tubular offset, select this skin, I'll make it 5. Very, very small. Okay, 10. Should be okay. You want it to be trim automatic. Then we intersect this, this, this. Hide this. It's okay. And then we will extend this. And then trim. Okay, cannot trim. And extend this as well. Extend. Trim. So these three surfaces, and then freeform blend, J2, chain select, continuity check. So what we have to do is copy this curve, this hide and select, copy paste here, paste here, unhide all, select this surface, this curve. Oh, we missed it. Okay, but yeah, align this curve to this blend. We'll project this surface of this curve. Yep, unhide all, select this, this curve, select, align this curve to this blend and project trim, and hide all, select this, this and this. Yep, and we create a blend here to here. We do a square. Explicit, so, do it as we see freeform blend, undo, chain select. Let's try this here. Select this, we'll delete its history and try to align it. It's fine. Oh, let's work on this side. So I'm going to skip this part. I mean, it's going to be the same procedure that I did for the side. So yeah.